What's going on, guys? It's your boy Ike from Ali8. In today's video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to throw in a soccer ball. And also, I'm going to be giving you guys tips and tricks on what to do to improve your long throws. So now, let's get into that video. Let's kick off the video by looking at these three rules made by the FA when you want to throw in a soccer ball. The first rule is that when you want to take a throw in, your body needs to be facing towards the field, so you can't take a throw in back in the field. The second rule is that your leg should be placed on the touchline or behind the touchline. Now, this field really isn't marked, so let's say somewhere here is our touchline. You can place your legs on the touchline or behind the touchline if you want to take a throw-in, but then your legs can't be in front of the touchline. Now, the third and final rule is that the player must throw the ball with both hands from behind and over his head from the point where the ball left the field. Now, over the years, we have seen the progression of throw-ins and how a long throw can be as effective as a set piece. If you watch football matches, you would see that it's not all about muscles that gives the player power to give a long throw. Rather, it's all about momentum. So now, let's look at what really is important. The first thing we want to think about when taking a long throw is our runner. If you want to take a long throw, you need to take like 4 or 5 steps back from the point where the ball left the pitch. This is because when going forward, it's going to give you the momentum to throw the ball inside and farther. Now, after you've taken 4 or 5 steps backwards, you'd want to start out with the ball in front of you. When you take 2 steps forward, you begin to take the ball behind your head and arc your back. This is going to build up momentum for your throw. When you get closer to the touchline, you then release the ball from over your head with both power and accuracy. Another thing I like to do when I want to take a long throw is to add a skip at the end of my run when I'm close to the touchline. This skip is not for decoration. This skip actually helps me to build both power and momentum from my legs, which goes through my back and comes out my hands. And it actually helps to make the ball go further when you want to take a long throw. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and learned something new. If you know you did, make sure you like the video and subscribe to my channel right here, because I give you guys tips and tricks which is going to make you a better football player. You can also check out this tutorial right here that's going to teach you how to perform a rainbow flick. But check out this playlist that is going to actually improve your skills as a footballer in general. So now, I'll be signing off. Goodbye.